For Rose on the Madred looks for the network to touch her tattoos. A touchy fighter's head would on the dimmers and the pesos and penway lose on the pesos and what's the end when locks on under what's the end the box and the push and the lessons and all these lessons which Hiram made to his Solomon for the house of the Lord with bright breath in the plain of shore. Cast them in the clay, thrown between soft hoof and sore. Burton and Solomon left all the lessons on. Wait, me to pay. Seed them and me. There was the way to the rest. From out and Solomon made all the lessons that were paid unto the house of the Lord. Whereupon the two bread was and the pen, those cakes of your gold fine on the right side and fine on the left before the oracle. Flowers and the lamps and the tons of gold and the bows and the snuffers and the bassons and the spoons and the censers. But your gold and the pimp is a gold both for the doors of the inner house, the most holy place, and for the doors of the to which are the temples of us and did all the attack in Solomon made for the house of the Lord. And Solomon in the things which David his father had made, the cake, the meal, and the silver, and the gold, and the Precious herbs did he open and the precious of the house of the Lord did bid first his appetite of the soul. We would drop in danger should it be beware of hands alone. Mama said, loved the embers of his real lead. All the heads of the tribes, the chief of the fathers of the children of Israel unto his Solomon in Jerusalem, that they might bring up the ark of the covenant unto the Lord out of the city of David, which is Zion, and all the men of Israel assembled hands and saw to his Solomon at the feast in the mountain in which his commandments and all the elders of Israel came, and the priests took up the ark, and they brought up the ark of the Lord and the tabernacle of the congregation and all the holy vessels that were in the tabernacle even. So did the priests and the Levites bring up and his Solomon and all the congregation of Israel that were assembled unto him were with him before the ark. Sacrifice indeed, and of songs that could not be told nor numbered. For multitude had the priests brought in the ark of the covenant of the Lord unto his place in to the oracle and the house to the most holy. Lived under the wings of the cherubims, for the cherubims spread forth their two wings over the place of the ark, and the cherubims covered the ark and the stage thereon above, and they drew out the stage, that the ends of the stage were seen out in the holy place before the oracle, and they were not seen without, and there they are unto this day. There was nothing in the ark save the two tables of stone, which Moses put there at Horeb when the Lord made a covenant with the children of Israel when they came out of the land. And it came to pass when the priests were come out of the holy place, that the cloud filled the house of the Lord, so that the priests could not stand to men, must to be chosen the cloud for the glory of the Lord had filled the house of the Lord. His face about and blessed all the congregation of Israel and all the congregation of Israel stood and he said, Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, which state which is now come to David my father, and that which is hand fulfilled it, saying, Since the day that I brought forth my people Israel out of Egypt, I chose now 50 out of all the tribes of Israel to build an house that my name might be there in the time. I chose David to be over my deed of Israel, and it was in the heart of David my father to build an house for the name of the Lord God of Israel. And the Lord said unto David my father, whereas it was in thine heart to build an house unto my name, thou didst dwell, that it was in thine heart, nevertheless, thou shalt not build the house that thy son hath shall come forth out of thy loins. He shall build the house unto my name, and the Lord hath performed his word that he stated. I am risen up in the room of David my father, and sit on the throne of Israel, as the Lord promised, and had built an house for the name of the Lord God of Israel. And I have set there a place for the ark wherein is the covenant of the Lord, which he made with our fathers when he brought them out of the land of Egypt. And Solomon stood before the altar of the Lord in the presence of all the congregation of Israel, and spread forth his hands toward heaven, and he said, Lord God of Israel, there is no God like thee in heaven above or on earth. Many true peace, best God, Lord, have mercy. With thy servants that walk before thee with all their heart, who hast kept with thy servant David, my father. That thou promisedst him shall stay fast also. With thy mouth and hast fulfilled it with thine hand, that it is his name. Therefore thou, Lord God of Israel, keep with thy servant David, my father, that thou promisedst him, saying, there shall not fail thee a man in my sight to sit on the throne of Israel. So let thy children take heed to their ways, that they walk before me as thou hast walked before me. And now, O God of Israel, let thy word, I pray thee, be thereof, which shall stay fast unto thy servant David, my father, that will God indeed dwell on the earth. Behold, the heaven and heaven of heavens cannot contain thee, how much less his house that I have builded. Yet hast thou respect unto the prayer of thy servant and to his supplication, O Lord my God, to hearken unto the cry and to the prayer which thy servant prayeth before thee today, that thine eyes may be opened towards his house night and day, lead towards the place on which thou hast said my name shall be there, that thou mayest hearken unto the prayer which thy servant shall make towards his place. And hearken thou to the supplication of thy servant and of thy people Israel, when they celebrate towards his place and hear how in heaven thy dwelling place, and when thou hearest, forgiveth any man trespass against his neighbor, and an oath be made.
There be
Here, how in heaven, then. Love, for four and two. For thou didst separate them from among all to be one, and the earth to be thine inheritance that shall stand fast by thy when Solomon had made an end of praying all his prayer and supplication unto the Lord, he arose from before the altar of the Lord. From kneeling on his knees, with his hands spread up to heaven, and peaceful and blessed all the congregation of Israel with a loud voice, saying, blessed be the Lord that hath given rest unto his people Israel, according to all that he promised. There hath not failed one word of all his good promise, which he promised by the hand of Moses his servant. The Lord our God be with us as he was with our fathers. Let him not leave us nor forsake us, that he may incline our hearts unto him to walk in all his ways and to teach his commandments and his statutes and his judgments which he commanded our fathers. And let these my words wherewith I shall before the Lord be nigh unto the Lord our God day and night, that he maintain the cause of his servant and the cause of his people Israel at all times, and commit to every quiet at all the people of the earth may know that the Lord is God, and that there is none else. Let your heart therefore be perfect with the Lord our God to walk in his statutes and to teach his commandments as at his day, and taught him and all Israel which him offered sacrifice me. For the Lord and Solomon offered a sacrifice on these offerings which he offered unto the Lord, 20,000 oxen and 120,000 sheep, so the and Olga. Children of Israel, at the gate of the house of the Lord the same day, did the king, hello, come in the Lord, the porch that was before the house of the Lord, for there he offered the offerings and meat offerings and the fat of the these offerings, because the brazen altar that was before the Lord was too little to receive the burnt offerings and meat offerings and the fat of the these offerings, and at times Lamb and the feast and all Israel with him a great congregation from the entering of Hamath unto the river. For the Lord our God sends on days and sends on days, even 14 days on the 8th day, he sent the people away and they blessed the hill and went on to their tents joyful and glad of heart, for all the goodness that the Lord had done for David his servant and for Israel his in the first Kings chapter 9, of God's holy word, the contains the John 16, when the man did came to pass, when Solomon had finished the building of the house of the Lord and the king's house, and all Solomon's desire which he was pleased to do, that the Lord appeared to Solomon the second time as he had appeared unto him at Gibeon. And the Lord said unto him, I have heard thy prayer and thy supplications that thou hast made before me. I have hallowed this house which thou hast built to put my name there forever, and mine eyes and mine heart shall be there perpetually. And if thou wilt walk before me as David thy father walked in integrity of heart and in uprightness, to do according to all that I had commanded thee, and wilt keep my statutes and my judgments, then I will establish the throne of thy kingdom upon Israel forever, as I promised to David thy From follow in me, ye or your children, and will not heed my commandments and my statutes which I have set before you, but go and serve after gods and worship them, then will I cut off Israel out of the land which I have given them, and his house which I have hallowed for my name, will I cast out of my sight, and Israel shall be a brother and a byword among all people, and that his house which is high every one's left us at night, it shall be astonished, and changes and patience say, why hath the Lord not us unto his land and to his house, and they shall answer, because they forsook the Lord their God who brought forth their fathers out of the land of Egypt, and had taken hold of the lesser gods, and had worshipped them and served them. Therefore has the Lord brought upon them all his evil, and came to pass at the end of 20 years, when Solomon had built the two houses, the house of the Lord and the his house, Mount Hiram, the hill of Tyre, had furnished Solomon with cedar trees and fir trees, and with gold according to all his desire, that had been Solomon built Hiram 20 cities in the land of Valley. And Hiram came out from Tyre to see the cities which Solomon had built, him and they pleased him not, and he said, what cities are these which thou hast built on me, my brother? And he told them the land of Abel unto this day, and Hiram said to the kings, extort a lump of gold, and this is the reason of the levy which is Solomon raised for to build the house of the Lord and his own house, and Millo and the wall
that were over.
150 which Meru loves a deep unfettered in power of Pharaoh's daughter came about us the city of David unto her house which Solomon had built for her, and did he build Milo and 3 times in a year did Solomon offer burnt offerings upon the altar which he did unto the Lord, and he burnt incense upon the altar that was before the Lord. So he and Hiram sent him to Navy, his servant shipment at Malach of the sea with the servants of Solomon, and they came to offer and fetched from hence gold 420 talents, and brought it to King Solomon, sending first his chapter 10 of God's holy word. The 10 pains were went between us. She heard of the fame of Solomon concerning the name of the Lord. She came to bruise him with her questions, and she came to Jerusalem with a very great train with 10 months at their spices, and very much gold and precious stones. And when she was come to Solomon, she communed with him of all that was in her heart, and Solomon told her all her questions. There was not any hidden from her in which she to turn up and tread between the sheep and evils alone of wisdom and the house that he had built and the meat of his table and the his ministers and bearers thereof, and his cupbearers and his ascent by which he went up unto the house of the Lord. Was not told me by wisdom and brass. Thereof he exceeded the fame which I heard. Had he your time and had he your his time. But which can continue me before the end that he died with the blessed be the which delight had in thee to set me on the throne of Israel, because the Lord loved Israel forever, therefore men and justice, and she made the him and her broad and 20 talents of gold and of spices, very great store and rare stones. There came no more such abundance of spices as these which the Queen of Sheba gave to him, Solomon and the Hiram had brought them from a third plenty among the trees and precious stones and the inlaid ivy alone. Trees still last for the house of the Lord and for the His house hearts also. And sanctuaries for sinners there came no such the trees nor was he but to his nay and in solemnation to the queen of she that which Solomon gave her of his royal bounty, so she turned and went to her own country, she and her servants now. Boat that came to Solomon in 1 year was 600 trees tall and 6 10 long such boat beside that he had undone men and the traffic of dust by merchants and of all the kings of Arabia and of the Gold 600 shekels of gold went to a target, and he made 300 shields of beaten gold, 300 gold went to a shield, and both men in the house of the forest of Lebanon, moreover, the king made a great throne of ivory, and overlaid it with the best gold. Throne had 6 steps, and the top of the throne was round behind, and there were stays on either side of the place of the seat, and two lions stood beside the stays, and 12 lions stood there on the one side and on the other. But on the 6 steps there was not the light made in any kind of man. O King Solomon's great inheritance was gold, and all the vessels of the house of the for us, cause when the mother was your old mother, but since it was not in account, Tabasin, Salaman, for the infinity of Asia's hardship with the Asia's high. Ramans in 3 years' time, some Asia's hardship brim in gold and silver, ivory and lace and detox soap in Salaman, exceeded all Tapinsan. The earth for riches and for wisdom and all the earth sought to Salaman to hear his wisdom which God had put in his heart and say, brought every man his present lessons of silver and lessons of gold and garments and arms, spices, horses and mules of great year by year, and Salaman had served to better chariots and horsemen, and he had 1,400 chariots and 12,000 horsemen, whom he did stow in the cities for chariots, and with the king at Jerusalem. And the king made silver to be in Jerusalem, as stones and cedars made he to be as the sycamore trees that are in the lane for abundance. And Salaman had horses brought out of Egypt, and linen yarn the king's merchants received the linen yarn at a price, and the chariot came up and went out of Egypt for 600 shekels of silver, and an horse 450, and so far all the kings of the Hittites and for the kings Assyria did they bring them out by their means in First Kings chapter 11 of God's holy word, the king paints the 16:11, but King Solomon loved many strange women to better with the daughter of Pharaoh in men of the Moabites and Moabites. The Mites, Sidonians, and Hittites of the nations concerning which the Lord said unto the children of Israel, ye shall not go into them, neither shall they come in unto you. For sure we say, winter the way your your heart hath prepared, but Solomon laid unto feet in love, and he had 700 wise princesses, and 300 concubines, and his wives turned away his heart, for it came to pass when Solomon was old that his wives turned away his heart after gods, and his heart was not perfect with the Lord his God, as was the heart of David his father. For Solomon went after at Toreth, the God of the Sidonians, and after Nidom, the Ammonite, among the Ammonites, and Solomon did evil in the sight of the Lord, and went not fully after the Lord, as did David his father. And did Solomon build an high place, for he moved the Ammonite above Moab in the hills that is before Jerusalem, and for Moab the Ammonite among the children of Ammon. And likewise did he for all his strange wives with burnt heads, and sacrificed unto their gods, and the Lord was angry with Solomon because his heart was turned from the Lord God of Israel, which had appeared unto him twice, and had commanded him concerning his sins, that he should not go after other gods, but he had not that which the Lord commanded. Wherefore the Lord said unto Solomon, for as much as his is done of thee, and thou hast not kept my commandment and my statutes which I had commanded thee, I will surely root the kingdom from thee, and will give it to thy servant not withstanding. In thy days I will not do it for David thy father's sake, but I will root it out of the hand of thy son. How may it I will not turn away all the kingdom, but will give one right to thy son, for David my servant's sake, and for Jerusalem's sake, which I had chosen, and the Lord stirred up an adversary of to Solomon, David, the Almighty, was not conceited in them, for it came to pass when David was in Edom, and Joab, the captain of the host, was gone up to bury the slain after he had smitten every male in Edom. For 6 months did Joab remain there with all Israel, until he had cut off every male in Edom, that had fled. He had set on Edom, might such his father's servant switch him to go into Egypt, had been yet a little child, and they arose out of Midian and came to Jared, and they took men with them out of Jared, and they came to Egypt, to Pharaoh, king of Egypt, which nation and house had appointed him, Jeshuas and nation led, and had found great favor in the sight of Pharaoh, so that he nation to wife the sister of his own wife, the sister of the Phoenix, the queen, and the sister of the Phoenix, there's change, and you that she's a true the Phoenix, we did Pharaoh's house, and then you that was in Pharaoh's household among the sons of Pharaoh, and when Hadad heard in Egypt that David slept with his fathers, and that Joab the captain of the host was dead, Hadad said to Pharaoh, let me depart, that I may go to my own country. And Pharaoh said unto him, but what hast thou left with me, that this old house seekest to go to thy And he had dwelt Hands and fit on Arma and pay to alone in the field and the high up of the moon. Arma had brought on him and bred it in 20.
Send me to God.
out my lane. There and I will take me and hope and dream up for him to all that guides all desire and shan't be till be it how in dark come unto all that I come and be and will walk in my ways and do that is right in my sight to my statutes and my commandments as they did my servant did that I will be with thee and bid thee up for houses for David and with Israel unto thee, and I win for his afflict the seed of David, but not for endless allurements of therefore to imperable amen. Jeroboam arose and fled in to Egypt to fight at Elah. Egypt and was in Egypt until the death of Saul. Laman and the rest, but the acts of Laman and all that he and his wisdom are hey, not written in the book of the acts of Solomon, and the time that Solomon reigned in Jerusalem over all was 40 years, and Solomon's left with his fathers and was buried in the city of David, his father and Rehoboam. Reigned in his tents in Bin. First Kings chapter 12, God's holy word taught him pains. John 16, he went on and to teach them for all Israel, word of unto peace, unto nation to love it came to pass when terrible on the Son of me that who was yet in Egypt heard of it, for he was fled from the presence of his Solomon and Jeroboam, dwelt in Egypt at his end, and told him and Jeroboam and all the above. Rabbeinu on Israel came and spake unto Rehoboam, saying, Thy father made our yoke grievous now. Therefore make us a breeze. Thus it is unto thy father and his heavy yoke, which he put upon us, lighten. We will serve thee and he said unto them, depart yet for 3 days. And come again to me and the people departed, and Henry Homolon consulted with the old man that stood before Solomon his father, while he yet lived, and said, How do ye advise that I may answer his people and his data? To him saying, If thou wilt be a servant, come to his people this day, and wilt serve them and answer, speak good words to them, and they will be thy servants forever. But he forsook the town. Solomon, the old man, they had been on him and consulted with the young men that were grown up with him and which stood before him. And he said unto them, What counsel will ye that we may answer his people who have spoken to me, saying, Make the yoke which thy father did put upon us, lighter, and the young men that were grown up with him spake unto him, saying, Thus shalt thou speak on to his people that spake unto thee, saying, Thy father made our yoke heavy, but make thou it lighter unto us. Thus shalt thou say unto them, My little finger shall be thicker than my father's loins, and now whereas my father did lade you with a heavy yoke, I will add to your yoke. My father hath chastised you with whips, but I will chastise you with scorpions. So Jeroboam and all the people came to Rehoboam the third day, as the hill had appointed, say, Then come to me again the third day. And the king answered the deep a rough. We and force of field, men's counsel, had salvation and stay to them after the council. Of the young men saying, my father made your yoke heavy, and I will add to your yoke, my father also chastised you with whips, but I will chastise you with scorpions, wherefore the head hath come not unto the people, for the dust was from the Lord, that he might perform his saying, which the Lord spake by Ahijah the prophet, might come to Jeroboam the son of Nebat, so when all Israel saw that the his heart come not unto them, the people answered the king, saying, what portion have we in David? Neither have we in Heraptons, in the son of Jesse. So Israel, now see to thine own house, David. So Israel departed unto their tents, but as for the children of Israel which dwelt in the cities of Judah, Rehoboam reigned over them, and in Rehoboam sent a door and drew us over the tribute, and all Israel stoned him with stones, that he died. Therefore in Rehoboam made steep to bitch him up to his chariot to flee to Jerusalem. So Israel rebelled against the house of David unto this day, and it came to pass when all Israel heard that Jeroboam was come again, that they sent and called him unto the congregation, and made him king over all Israel. There was none that followed the house of David but the tribe of Judah only. And when Rehoboam was come to Jerusalem, he assembled all the house of Judah with the tribe of Benjamin, and 144,000 chosen men which were warriors to fight against the house of Israel. to print a kingdom of victory. Rehoboam, the son of Solomon, the power of God came unto Shemaiah, the man of God, saying, speak unto Rehoboam, the son of Solomon, king of Judah, and unto all the house of Judah and Benjamin, and to the realm of Tush, the people, saying, thus saith the Lord, ye shall not go up nor fight against your brethren, the children of Israel, written an agreement to his house, for his sin is from me, say, hark, God. Therefore, to the word of the Lord and written to depart according to the word of the Lord, said Jeroboam, build ye solid mount ye freedom, and dwelt therein, and went out from thence, and built Benol, and Jeroboam said in his heart, now shall the kingdom return to the house of David, if his people go up to do sacrifice in the house of the Lord at Jerusalem, and shall the heart of his demon turn again unto their Lord, even unto Rehoboam, king of Judah, and say, shall kill me, and go again to Rehoboam, king of Judah, whereupon the king took counsel and made two tents of gold and said unto them, it is too much for you to go up to Jerusalem. Behold, thy gods, O Israel, which brought thee up out of the land of Egypt, and he set thee on in Bethel, and thee are set up here in Dan, and this sin became a sin for the went to worship before thee, one kneeling unto them, and he made an house, a high places, and made priests of the lowest of the which were not of the sons of Levi, and came Sneo shamat laita to the feast dedicated to the empty sacrifice in unto the hands that he had made, and he placed in as of the priests of the high places which he had made. So offered up on the altar which he had made in this of the 15th day of the 8th month, even in the month which he had devised of his own heart and ordained the feast unto the children of Israel, and he offered up on the altar and burnt incense in their first hymns, chapter 13 of God's holy word. The King James Version, 1611, and behold,